Yeah, it's GT here again. Wanted to kind of do a follow-up. I have a couple of videos on food and health and marketing and propaganda and stuff like that, or at least I have some videos that include those things. But today, just want to add a little bit more information and maybe clarify or whatever. What irritates me about the food marketing and the foods that are generally accepted as health foods and all that is, you know, marketing. And the FDA and the USDA, at, you know, these are simply fascist bankster-backed consumer killers. corporatism run wild with our so-called government. You know, so all the conspiracy theory stuff aside, whether or not these things were intentionally placed into our diet as a slow kill method or as a means to make one sick, thereby requiring medical attention and a plethora of pharmaceutical, who knows, you know. But the thing is that, you know, a sick person or one who has dis-ease usually requires medical attention and is usually prescribed various and sundry pharmaceuticals, and you know, this is like a subscription, a never-ending subscription of vast and huge quantities, or as a percentage of one's income. It's like, you know, if I could get somebody to just pay me, you know, let's say $25 a month, every month, month after month, year after year, decade after decade, until the day they die. I wish I had the formula for that. Well, the big mad big pharma do have a formula, and it just may not be so much of a coincidence that everything that we eat just tends to produce disease, dis-ease, inflammation, alter, you know, our gut bacteria, invade or pass through our messed up gut and increase food allergies and all that. And, you know, the list goes on and on. But basically, I'm just going to say they lie, okay? And when I say they, I mean the powers that be or the marketing powers that purvey the poison to our mind, which then ends up purveying poison to our body because we have a certain belief that something is good for us or that eating this food will, you know, help me lose weight or whatever, you know, it's all marketing. And, you know, like I said, who knows if for sure underlying whether these people actually know that these things are poisoning you, but when you look at the evidence all together, with the GMO stuff and, you know, the chemicals that they put in our food, and these non-food items and things like soy and, you know, canola. What is this stuff, and why are we eating this? Why do they put that in everything, you know? Okay, well, anyway, I mean, I'm just going to go through a few examples of the propaganda which poisons our mind, which then, in turn, produces a behavior change or a behavior such as purchasing a product, and then in turn the product, consuming the product, which makes us sick. Well, first I'm going to go to like really something pretty basic to everyone's diet is oils. And, you know, there was a marketing play back quite a while ago which was wholly responsible for switching over basically everybody's habit from eating butter, for example, which is something that everyone, you know, pretty much eats in the United States, at least of European descent and what have you. Well, you know, back in the day, there was an advertising campaign to demonize any kind of animal-based fats like dairy and, of course, lard and anything fatty in meat. Well, you know, that was because they had this other product in mind to replace it, and it was made out of plants, and it, you know, it seemed like, well, you know, maybe plant-based oils would be good for you or better for you, you know. Anyway, it was a total brainwashing marketing scam, basically. And in a similar methodology and similar occurrences, people, you know, were convinced to use like Crisco, hydrogenated oils and stuff like that. I'm going to continue on. Now, another example in the same vein is the use of corn oil. You know, I mean, look in your grocery store shelves, majority of the oil is corn oil or canola oil, or, you know, this stuff is total crap. Especially now. See, once they've established this behavior pattern, we're going to buy corn oil. Well, then, you know, sometime in the, you know, in the 90s, mid-90s, without our knowledge or you know, acquiescence even, I mean, because we don't know or we didn't know about it, they basically engineered a new corn called genetically modified corn, or GMO, genetically modified organism. Well, the same could be said for soybean oil and cottonseed oil and canola oil. Okay, all of these main oils that we now use and that are available and that are, you know, ubiquitous in everything we eat, damn near everything, are genetically modified, and they are toxic. Not only are they not good for us, but they are bad for us in many, many ways. Now, you know, in the not too distant past, there was a push to replace, like in fast food restaurants and such, they were talking about replacing the oils that they used, which were, you know, good and they were tasty and whatever, for making french fries and all the deep fried crap and all that. And a lot of that was fairly good for you or not horribly bad for you and all that. And that included, you know, some animal fats and stuff like that. Well, now, they said, hey, that stuff is terrible for you. And it's making us sick and all that. And you gotta go to these plant-based oils. Well, you know. And then, okay, so they did that under pressure and it changed over. And now our fries and stuff aren't good. You know, they're not nearly as good as they used to be. In fact, you know, I don't even know what they are anymore. You know. But anyway, so... It went from saturated fat to trans fat. So this trans fat is like really bad for you. So we went through a period of years now where we have been inundated with trans fat and, you know, all these different artificial... manufactured oils and fats from genetically modified organisms that used to be called corn and soybean and canola and cottonseed. Now, you can't really call it cottonseed because it's not even, or corn oil or any of those. You can't really call them that because whatever they are, they're not corn, they're not soybean, they're not canola, and, you know, who knows what they really are. One thing we know for sure is on the limited studies that have been made, you know, suggest they're pretty horribly bad for everybody, and promote disease and inflammation you know, they're just they've opened up Pandora's box with this genetic crap that they're purveying upon us. Alright, so, you know, I don't know if this is a purposeful deception program, and this is really a soft kill thing on any level. I mean, but the thing is that, indeed, this stuff is killing us. And if you look in like at the other, well, just as a, you know, an example, the other day I went to go find some mayonnaise, you know, or a salad dressing type of thing or something. And I began to look at all the labels, and I went to, and I'm looking at, you know, salad dressing, any kind, and it's like canola oil. Oh, some of them were even the first ingredient was water, which see, you know, hey, you know, whatever. But okay, water, oil, canola oil was in all that stuff. So, you know, or soybean oil. Well, it was either soybean or canola or both combined to make these products. Well, this stuff is poison, you know. I mean, for one thing, it's you can't even call it corn oil or soy oil or canola oil because we don't even know what that organism is now. That they've played with the genetics. And it's all horribly bad for you. You know, so I didn't buy any. And that's what you should do. I tell you what, if these people are told, hey, I'm not taking this crap. You're not gonna sell me this crap. I'm not eating your crap. You're selling crap. Quit doing it. I don't want it. I'm not gonna buy it. Okay, this is the solution. You know, I'm getting ahead of myself. Okay, so we got this oil thing going. So, you know. What do you eat instead, or what should you use? Okay, or no. I'm gonna go back just a little bit and say what to avoid. Anything with corn oil, anything with soybean oil, or any of its byproducts in all these, you know, corn syrup solid, high fructose corn syrup, you know. Blah blah blah. Same thing with soybean oil and soybeans. You know, we don't. This is a hormone. I mean, this is a hormone mimetic, which raises estrogen. This is something we don't need in our diet. It isn't food. Okay, cottonseed, so-called cottonseed. Anything with that in it, you know, avoid it. Don't buy it. Don't, you know. Stay away from it. All that stuff is toxic, it's poison, it's really, really bad for you. And it's been shown with studies that say, for example, high fructose corn syrup is a replacement for sugar or a supplement of sugar, or, you know, they put it in everything. And it has been shown to, I mean, it's like energizes cancer, and it produces all kinds of bad effects. It acts differently than sugar. You know, look it up. There's studies out there showing how toxic it is. Now, this stuff is in everything we eat. Okay, wheat bread, stuff like that. Okay, I'm going off. Okay, so quit buying that crap. You know, instead, you know, and get rid of your margarine. You know, any kind of margarine that they got, it's plant-based, it's probably trans fat, and regardless, it's probably not made with any kind of good oil that you would want to put in your body. So you want to go to 100% real and hopefully organic butter, but I mean, I don't know about organic anymore as far as true availability of such a thing, or even, you know, what such an animal might be. But, real butter. I mean, if you're going to lather something on your bread, or put it in a recipe, or whatever, you might as well get the good stuff, you know. It doesn't have trans fats in it. Oh, man. So, but, you know, okay, the point of it is that they use marketing and brainwashing techniques on you to get you to buy this stuff, touting that it's better for you than that other stuff over there. But it's a lie. Not only is it just made to make some particular company some money, but it ends up that in most cases what they're trying to purvey to you is toxic and poisonous to your body. Okay? The same thing could be said, like, for the food pyramid. You know, I've got a thing on that. You know, yeah, let's go to the feed market, the feed lot, and just totally pig out on a bunch of grains that have no food value. It's sugar. It's just sugar. You might as well just get you a big bowl of GMO sugar and just, because, you know, that's what you're doing, you know. Eat some bread, yeah. Eat some cereal. Have a big bowl of cereal. Here's what you should have for breakfast, you know. 2 slices of toast with margarine. A bowl of cereal. And a small glass of orange juice. You know, this is a healthy breakfast, you know. And what is it? It's freaking sugar. It just goes, you know, what little that you can use right away will give you a spike in your insulin and your blood sugar. Goes way up. What you can't use right away is immediately, you know, transformed into fat, and then we're carrying around all this fat, you know, with us all day, and it is very resistant to coming off. You know, once your body puts some fat on, it's like, no, you ain't getting none of that. We're saving that for a rainy day. Well, the problem is, you know, nowadays, there ain't ever a rainy day, you know, because we're constantly shoveling in more sugars and, you know, bad fats and all that, you know. It's, our diet is horrible, and the food that we can purchase that's available in the supermarket, I'd say 80 to 90% of it's probably toxic, harmful, or just, you know, generally non-nutritious. But there's always a marketing campaign or a process or a brainwashing propaganda campaign to promote certain foods that certain companies are making money on. You know, big money. You know, how can you take, you know, something that we have had, like, surpluses of for generations, corn, you know, wheat. We don't even know what to do with it. It got so much. So breaking it down into components, and they're putting it, all that stuff, into other food as fillers and substitutions for, you know, other things and all that. So, I mean, what you got is a bunch of cheap, over surplus foods that and most of them are grains or GMO fake food, whatever the hell they are, and they're in almost everything. Now this stuff is making us sick. It's making us fat, and it's killing us, you know. The GMO stuff, you know, if you don't know about GMOs, I don't know where you've been. Like, what planet are you on if you don't know about GMOs, and if you don't, if you haven't taken the time to look up about what they are, then I blame you because you're lazy or stupid or just plain ignorant, you know. I don't know, but I'm telling you, you know, I don't have time to go through all the problems with GMOs and what they are and all that, but I can just tell you right offhand, they're not food. Okay? You get it? It's poison. Okay? The end result is sick, fat people, which they really love. They love you when you're sick. They love you when you're fat, because then they can sell you diet foods. Yeah, all the diet food, most of them probably make you fat too, and or don't help you to lose weight or anything like that. Most of them are just chock full of chemicals and empty, you know. Even they've got zero cal stuff, but it's got chemicals in it and stuff that you don't want to, you know, take into your body. You know? We need to stay away from chemicals and additives and preservatives and food colorings and all this, insecticides and herbicides and homicides and whatever. You know, we eat badly. I'll just say we eat horrible stuff here. What's available in the shelves and stuff here is, one source, you know, I keep referring back to about 80 to 85% of the stuff that's on our grocery store shelves would be banned in you know, over 30 countries, I know, but quite a few. And the GMO, you know, why is everybody else outlawing it and getting, you know, why is China not accept our GMO corn shipments and stuff like that? Well, because it's poison. You know, we're not pulling them. They're not taking, and they say, no, we're not taking your crap. You take that and shove it. And that's what we should be saying. If you don't understand that you've been deceived your entire life about what's good for you and what's not, and that doesn't make you mad, then, you know, you've been programmed. That's all there is out there, so I guess I'll have to eat it. You know, it's like, you know, I just can't hardly keep from pulling the trigger on this gun, because it, you know, it's made to be pulled. my God. Well, I may be going on and on here, but the thing is that, you know, everything that they've taught you that, or told you, or programmed you with, or, you know, this line that they put out from the FDA and the food pyramid and the marketing schemes and all that, it's all about them, somebody making money at your expense. And then the end result is that you get sick and you get fat. And then think about it. You know, who are you going to go to? Oh, well, you're either going to buy some foods or whatever, some other products that, like diet foods and stuff, so you can, you know, lose weight. You know, it doesn't happen, does it? Huh. Wonder why. And, you know, the people who get sick, increasingly, end up going into, you know, the doctor's office or the hospital or whatever, and getting put on medications of all different kinds, which you never get off of. It's just a subscription. It's not a prescription, it's a subscription. You pay me X amount of dollars every month for the rest of your life. That's what it is. Most of the drugs that they put out and most of the treatments that they give are toxic or harmful in many ways and hardly even effective. In fact, I believe the threshold is like 5 to 15% of the people of, in general, will benefit from any particular drug as far as symptomology relief. And that's all that is. The drug, big pharma, big med system is simply designed and promulgated and propagated to get a subscription out of you. And then there's the whole, you know, insurance company, government. Well, why are they in that? You know, because it's big money. You know, that's their cronies and their crony politicians. Obamacare is written by, you know, the insurance company. And the insurance companies love that system. And Big Med loves that system. And Big Pharma loves that system. And the people who send you there, Big-Agra. Everybody benefits except you, the people. You're sick and you're paying more and more and more of your percentage of your income, as it's kind of like a health tax, isn't it? Think about it. Do you get it? I mean, it's corporate fascist, and then, you know, with our government involved now, social fascist. I don't know what you call it, but, you know, it's a corporate whore, government sanctioned or sanctified or modified or whatever process, you know. Alright, lastly, I'm just going to talk about chemicals in your food, you know, chemicals in your environment, you know. There are just hundreds of preservatives and chemicals, and, you know, I mean, besides the stuff that isn't supposed to be in there, like pesticides and herbicides, all that, in your food. You know. And the stuff doesn't ever go bad, you know. I mean, you can have a loaf of white bread sitting around, or in my case, I put it in the fridge because it takes me a long time to even eat the loaf of bread. And usually I try to get like a deli bread or something like that, although I'm not sure if that's really any different or not. I mean, not that much different. But I mean, this stuff never goes bad. So, how does that happen? I mean, this is bread. You remember? I don't know if you remember, but I remember a time when bread used to go bad. You know, even bread that you got from the store. You know, it molds, it breaks down, you know, it goes bad. I don't know what they're putting in there. I mean, look at the bag label. See, but there's nothing good in it, and then they put bad stuff on top of it. So, you know, we got chemicals, petrochemicals, you know, and then they've fortified most of your grain items because they don't really have any after they process the flour and all that. There's nothing left of any food value whatsoever in it. So they fortify it. Well, these are usually some chemicals that and you know, synthetic vitamins and minerals or whatever, and even metallic flakes for iron. Yeah, really. I mean, I saw this guy took a box of cereal and mixed some water with it, crunched it up, blended it up, and then had a magnet at the bottom of the bag, and you know, it drains out the liquid and all that, cuts the magnet off, and then the inside of the bag, there's a bunch of metal little flake particles stuck to the magnet. And that's their iron. Ooh. You know, who knows what that does, you know, to your gut line. Well, anyway, I mean, chemicals. They're all over in your food, okay? And they propose that you use chemicals of all different kinds to clean your house with and all that. Well, you know, no. Bad. Food coloring and, you know, anything. There's just hardly anything out there that is even good for you. You know, you have to realize that the stuff that's in the store is our food-like products or pseudo-food. Most of, you know, one, people have to understand that they need to start eating real food, and they need to quit pasteurizing and homogenizing and all this kind of crap, because you know, that takes away all the enzymes that we need to digest and process the food. Like whole milk, you know, whole milk is good for you. And that's why they kind of, you know, really don't want you to have whole milk. Think about it. I mean, they're arresting people and doing SWAT raids on people who are, you know, keeping whole milk and trying to trade it or sell it or whatever, and with the full knowledge and permission of the person buying. Why can't you have whole milk? Why can't you have whole milk cheese and all that? Because it's good for you? Well, you gotta really start thinking. That may just be one of the most telling things. And you know, there's a trend towards demonizing and prosecuting and ordinance making with regard to, you know, gardening in your yard and all that. Like, no, you can't have a garden, huh? You bet your boots, if I got a piece of land out back or out front, and it's mine, I'm going to put some food on, real food. And, you know, you should too. These are things that I've already, you know, talked about in other videos. But the thing is, there's so many chemical additives and crap in everything we eat, and then, you know, on top of that, if you're buying canned goods, a lot, in many cases, with certain foods, especially acidic foods, you got a BPA-laced can lining. And then, you know, all our meats and all our, you know, all of our beef, chicken, and pork and all that, these are all being fed GMO corn and soybeans and all that GMO crap. And then, you know, they're laden with hormones and growth hormones and antibiotics and all that. All these things are really bad for us. Okay, so what do we do? What do we do about that? Well, one thing that I do, or what the, you know, one of the things that I do is I, you know, like try to source things from close to home and from people who are connected to actually growing or raising, you know, food items, you know, like eggs, you know. Now, granted, most people aren't going to have, you know, access to processed meat, you know, meat packers, whatever. There may be some meat packers in your region or in your city or town or whatever that you could go and say, well, hey, is there anybody here who wants to sell me some, you know, bulk meat or whatever? That would be a good idea. I mean, I would do the same with the chicken and the pork and all that. You know, if you can get the stuff that's close to home and that, you know, is raised by a farmer and not from a feedlot or a corporation or whatever that's mass producing, mass fattening and producing these sickly animals that they end up butchering, and then we get to eat all their hormones and antibiotics and GMO corn-fed beef, you know. We don't want that stuff, okay? Anything that's processed in any way, shape, or form is going to be much less nutritive, whatever, and probably has been radiated or heat pasteurized or something, and we need to avoid processed foods. I mean, quit buying stuff in a box, you know, hamburger helper. The secret of the thing about food and eating is that if it's easy and fast, you probably don't want it. I mean, and there's a reason why we used to have a system of, you know, where the man went to work, you know, and the woman stayed home and took care of the house, the cooking, the cleaning. These are both vital, important aspects of having, you know, a family. But now it's everybody's working, so nobody has time to actually prepare food. You understand? Preparing food. You need to take real ingredients and combine them yourselves and process them as little as possible, heat them as little as possible, and eat them, okay? Now, I know there's a lot of raw food gurus and all these weirdos and wackos and stuff out there. They've got something there. There's something there. Yeah, raw food is good for you, you know. But, yeah. Anybody who says don't eat meat or don't eat fat is a nut, you know, because, you know, your skin, the largest organ in the body, is a great deal, a percentage, high percentage of fat. Your brain is, you know, predominantly fat and proteins, you know. We need fats and proteins too, you know, and there are vegetable alternatives to meat if you just totally can't or don't want to eat meat. You know, I'm not saying you can't, or I'm not saying anything bad directly against that, but there are things in meat that you just can't get anywhere else. And I believe that the fats and the stuff that you get and the proteins that you get out of meat are really good for you, you know, and these things, you know, we need to incorporate into our diet. To all you, you know, vegans and all that, I mean, I don't know what you're gonna do, but, you know, if you're a control freak about your diet, you know, you might look at some psychological issues, because it's just food, you know, and it's good food. Probably gonna get some flack for that, but, you know, I'm not a radical, you know, vegetarian or anything like that. I mean, a lot, you know, we don't need that much meat in our diet, but say, for example, if I make a big pot of green soup, you know, with kale and spinach and different greens, collard greens and what have you, well, you know, by itself, it may be okay, but it sure is a lot better if you put some, you know, a couple slices of, you know, pork or chicken or beef or something in it, you know. And you can make a big pot of soup, and it's real good and tastes good. And it's got a lot of good stuff in it, and, you know, if you cook it at a low heat for, you know, and make a stew, kind of a soup or whatever out of it. I eat a lot of that, but, you know, it improves the flavor and it gives you a more rounded kind of thing, you know. That's just me. You know, I'm not telling you how to eat, but, you know. Anyway, this is getting on in length, and I'm not sure I really wanted to do such a grand video. But the thing is, going back, and kind of as a summary here, you know, people are telling you that certain foods, oh, you shouldn't eat that, and you should eat this instead. One has to look at their motives, and probably somebody that they're supporting or, you know, being the wah-wah-wah-wah mouthpiece for is making money on that, regardless of the real health benefits or not. You know, I went to Canada a few years back. It's been a while back now. When I go out into public in the United States, and like go to Walmart or whatever, you know, everybody's fat, you know, and I am pretty sure everybody's probably sick. I mean, there's some really grossly obese, fat people here, and they're everywhere. I mean, almost everybody is overweight. And many of them grossly overweight. This is a function of all the chemicals, the BPAs, the plastics, the petrochemicals, all around us and surround, you know, the food storage, you know, don't get me all started on that. Food storage containers and, you know, can linings and, you know, bottles, water bottles with BPA in them, and baby bottles with BPA and all that. You know, the chemicals, the stuff that ain't supposed to be in there. And we're just surrounded by this stuff. It's in our food, it's in our water, it's in our canned goods, it's in our processed food. There's GMOs that we have no idea what they even are, much less what they do to your body, because, you know, they're generally accepted as safe by the FDA or the USDA or both, you know, even though they never did any human testing. But I've seen some really bad things about GMOs, and doesn't seem to alarm anybody. Like three generations of eating a GMO diet, the species basically is unable to procreate anymore. They're sterile. They're small. They're sick. They die early, and you know, you name your poison. And there's probably a study out there that's been done on it that shows negative results. And don't be looking for any more of them to come up, because they're not going to get funded, people. Now that does suggest that somebody has an agenda to make you sick and to keep you in that subscription zone. Yeah. What's it all about? Anyway, I think I just diverged right off onto that leg, but chemicals. We got these chemicals all around us. We need to eliminate these, you know, from our environment, from our food, and you know, get some glass. You know, store your stuff in mason jars or whatever. You know, I'm going on. I'm ranting. But what I was trying to say was, you know, everybody's freaking fat and sick here, you know. And then I go to Montreal, right, and I look around. I got to go to a conference, a neuroscience conference or whatever, I believe it was. And I go around, I'm looking around at the people, and I just don't see big, fat people everywhere. They're all lean, and they look good, and they're beautiful people. I'm going, whoa. I mean, where's all those sick, fat bastards, you know? I mean, they're everywhere here. Think about it, you know. In Europe, you know, I mean, they basically, you know, outlawed GMOs and stuff. And, you know, look at the people there. Are they big, fat bastards, sick bastards, too? I don't know. You know, I mean, I haven't been there, but maybe people who have. What do you think? What's in the food? That they're giving you, that they're promoting to you. Why are you sick and why are you fat? And why don't you care? Why aren't you doing something about it? Really? Don't you get it? You need to wake up. Wake up, America, you're being poisoned, and food is your poison. Your poison is your food, and it leads to all the subscriptions that you end up having. And if you think it's a conspiracy, it well may be, but I don't have any proof of that. It just, you know, you take one and make two out of it. Makes sense, doesn't it? You know, and to think that, you know, it's all about somebody making a few bucks, and, you know, who cares about the peons and the peasants, you know. We've got our organic food growing right here. So who cares about them? The hell with them. These are the people who are they that run the puppeteers and all that. And they run the government, and they run you, and they run you into the ground, and they take your money. to rob you, to make you sick, and they sought to kill you. Nobody cared. Do you care? If you care about yourself and your kids and next generation down and all that, you will, number one, look it up. Test it. Test everything I said. You know, test. Look it up. Number two, quit eating the crap and start demanding that the food purveyors, your supermarkets and or companies, quit putting that crap in your food. Demand good food and protest with your pocketbook. How do you do that? You tell them, I'm not going to freaking eat your crap. Write in to them, email them, tell them, your crap has this crap in it, and why does it have it in there? And this stuff is making me sick and making me subscribe medications that I don't need that make me sick. And I'm not going to buy your crap until you get it out of there. Okay? If everybody did that right there, this would just instantly stop. Okay. And then number three, you gotta use food as a tool to make yourself healthy instead of sick. Okay. Your food is your medicine, your medicine is your food. So start eating right. Go in there, and if you have
to, it's 11 o'clock.
Simply look at the labels. If there's crap in there, don't buy it. If there's crap in the stuff that you got in your shelf, throw it away. It's not worth your health. It's not worth risking your health. Begin to buy things, if possible, which are processed very little or not at all. If you want to eat, whole grains and stuff like that, then get the grain. Or get a whole grain flour or whatever and make your own bread or something. You don't have to put all the crap in it that they put in it to preserve it for forever. Like you could be buried with a loaf of bread and open up the coffin, 100 years later, and the freaking bread still probably still be there. I am going on. But start eating. It takes time to prepare food. You process it yourself and use as little heat as needed, and look up, since if you already did number one, look up and test it and whatever, look it up, then you know what foods are going to be good and which ones aren't, and then make it yourself, and use items that are local if possible. Go to a farmer's market or whatever, get some good fresh vegetables and stuff and eat that. Find an avenue for getting some fresh eggs from a purveyor that doesn't cage a million birds in one big warehouse thing, where they're all sick and whatever. Whatever you get at, garbage in, garbage out. If you got garbage, if it's garbage, then what are you going to be eating? You're going to be eating a bunch of hormone, antibiotic filled stuff, and eggs. Get some farm fresh eggs. There's people around. I'm sure there's people in your city or your town or whatever that have, that raise chickens and have eggs. Look in the paper. It's probably eggs. stuff like that. Stay away from plastic containers. Stay away from plastic water bottles. Try to buy things like, especially acidic things like pasta sauce and stuff like that in jars. Or simply make your own pasta sauces and stuff out of fresh stuff if you can, you know. Buy a lot of frozen vegetables and things. Those are cheap and they're easy to store and they don't go bad. You can just take out what you need and all that kind of thing. Put them in soups and, you know, whatever you do with them. You know, if you start to eat right and avoid the chemicals and the preservatives and all that, and you'll just naturally begin to lose weight, you know. And, you know, quit eating bread, you know, in general, you know. Really, avoid carbs of all kinds if you can, really. I mean, that's my, I can't and I don't. Understand, you know, that I say stay away from it, but, you know, I still eat bread and stuff. But I got some non-fortified whole wheat bread flours and stuff like that, and I'm going to make my own bread, you know, so I know what's in it. And things like that. I mean, these are things that you can do, to actively do. You know, change your diet, change the way that you eat, and your health will improve, you'll lose weight, you know. Stay away from GMOs. And I don't know why I didn't say it before when I was talking about GMOs, but I just want to put this in. It's imperative. Sugar. If something says it's got sugar in it, okay, more than likely, I'd say probably 90, maybe 95% of the sugar is made from GMO beets, and so it's fake. It's not only just crap, because sugar is basically crap. Processed sugar of any kind is really crap. But if you have to use any kind of sugar, or if there's sugar in anything that you're buying, it's probably GMO. So if it says sugar or soybean oil or canola oil or whatever, you probably don't want it. You understand? That takes out about, whoop, it goes about 85% of the stuff on the shelf, right? Well, that's good. But if you have to do sugar, then make sure it's 100% cane sugar because it's not GMO. And then use it in very small quantities. I would recommend that you get stevia, which is probably the only safe alternative out there to sugar. If you just need the sweetness in something, you know, use stevia or like honey or, pure, real honey and or 100% cane sugar. Brown sugar is better than white sugar, you know, because it's not as processed and it's not bleached out. So that's one of the things I really wanted to put in. I don't know why I didn't think of it earlier, but, you know, it's a GMO product now. So stay away from sugar, for the most part, sugar. Stay away from carbs, for the most part. And, you know, look on YouTube. There's a whole bunch of things about whole grains and all that. The lies that they're telling you now, whole grain this, whole grain that. If you look at this stuff, there's lots of people, doctors, very intelligent people, health nuts and all that, and they all tell you, don't eat the crap. It's a lie. Okay, and that goes back to the start. And that says, like, they're lying to us about stuff. They're telling you one thing, and it's just making somebody money somewhere. But it's making you sick. It's making you fat. And it's making you get subscriptions for life. So quit being a sucker, wake up. And peace, love, and power be to all my viewers.